Okay, so the big kahuna of space talk, Mr. Hawking, Stephen Hawking, passed away just the last couple of days. Now, interesting. I never met him. I did watch his movie twice in a row, once in the movie theater, but I never met him, which is sad in a way. My father did meet him on an airplane of all places. He had to move out of the seat for Mr. Hawking, just move away, and so he could have a place to sit down. So it's kind of interesting. And I'm like, well, did he say anything to you? You know, did you get any good information? Any space talk? No, there was nothing. He had to get on the airplane, and he had his two handlers that helped him, and that was that. So that's the close link I have to Mr. Hawking. I don't know, all of this time out here on this internet, all of this time we discuss space, we talk about space a lot. Maybe he came across me a little bit, I don't know. But it's not the point. The point I actually wanted to talk about was a little bit about him, about what I remember. His big discussion, he talked about the waves of space and how space bends. I'm sorry, there's a fly in here. Yeah, how space bends, and it's not always straight. It's not always the same shape. So those types of things are very interesting to bring into what I wanted to talk about tonight, was about wavelengths. And I mean wavelengths of discussion, wavelengths of mind, thoughts, and travel. So you say, I'm on the same wavelength with you, you know. I'm really on that wavelength. I think like you. And so right now, I'm like in the kitchen, you know, just a few minutes ago, and I'm like, yeah, I'm on the wavelength right now, and I'm talking about wavelengths in my head. I'm thinking about those, and my focused energy is all in that direction. And I only really want that discussion with other people that are on that same wavelength, you know. Even if it's the repartee in your head that you have of your own yay or nay, no, that doesn't work, or that doesn't jive. That particular wavelength, those discussions in your head strengthen that wavelength, you know, strengthen your concentration factor and your focus on it. And there are other wavelengths going on, like you can have somebody, you know, just enter the room and have some little basic discussion about nothing really, you know, just something simple and something not a focused idea or anything, just something trivial. And that discussion, that wavelength can just be short-lived, and you hear it, and it's just like, well, do I want to listen to the whole thing? And you have the attention span in your own brain. Here we are, these little planets walking around. So we have this attention span in our own brain. As how long am I going to listen? How long am I actually going to listen to that trivial? Because I'm really focused in this other train of thought. I'm really longevity talking about it so much. I'm out here making a video. This other little thought was something about the kitchen, about some food item. Okay, so that one drops off and is gone. And the other, but then I'm like, well, wait a minute. That's just me at that moment. That's the wavelength I prefer to share. And I'm honing in on this other wavelength, this discussion of wavelengths and precision. So over here is the one, the trivial one. Now, I could be completely consumed by this little trivial one, and that could be my wavelength, and so I could just turn and alter and follow it and cut off this one that I was discussing. So if I turn and I change my wavelength concentration factor, and I'm like, oh, that's much more interesting. I'm interested in it, even though it's silly and it's not deep concentrative, it's shallow and something that I may hear in another hour. You know, it's that small, but I want to focus on that. And so that, and then you meet people in your life, and some people just like only focusing on those wavelengths, those little small, trivial, trippy ones. And I'm like, well, that's their life. That's where they are comfortable. They're attracted to those wavelengths. And so we can almost say, if you're attracted to the wavelength, you're attracted to that discussion. It's like being attracted to some kind, I will say, a magnetic pull. There is something in us as planets, as our own head space planets, body space planets, that we choose that was the one, that was the wavelength I want to hang out on, you know. And like whenever it happens again, it just is something that perks me up, and it's just a yes, you know. That is the discussion wavelength. And yet I may never get along with that person, you know what I'm saying, and I'm only getting along with this other one that wants to hear this discussion. He wants to talk about wavelengths and wavelength travel. And how far do they go? I mean, here I am, this big planet, self, and I'm talking. I mean, how far does it go? I mean, in my body realm space, as far as I talk, or as far as I sing, as far as I let it out, you know, you have that orbital effect of your own, you could say your own gases, your own auric expulsions. You have that going on. And, well, it's not really what I wanted, though, because that doesn't take a wavelength that connects to another wavelength that somebody else wants to hear along the way, that bolsters up your wavelength and makes it stronger and more concentrative, like a meditation when you have 100 or 1,000 or a million people all meditating. When you have a bolstered up wavelength, yeah, that's the one that is the, it's not just your little planet here and you're having your moment space. It's when your planet starts to connect with another, and another. And that is when the wavelengths start to become extremely interesting to me. And so oddly, that becomes an interesting wavelength factor. So this one person, remember, who wanted the short wavelength and the short trivial, they're extremely interested, and that's their interested wavelength factor also. And they're just going to go that direction with those people, and I'm going to go this direction with those others. Do you understand? And so we have all of these wavelengths that are passing by us all the time. I mean, you can say, well, we have the telephones, we have the Wi-Fi telephones, those waves. No, I'm talking actually your own head waves, your own head space waves are very powerful. You know, your thoughts. You say, well, oh, I was thinking about you, and then somebody calls on the telephone. It's like, oh, hi, I was thinking about you also. Those types of waves are very, very strong. So this is the... that connectivity wave. So when we're even out here on the internet, it's like, I'm interested in this topic. And I look it up, and I'm connecting with those people. It's a network, isn't it? We're on that network wavelength together. We may not always jive with the same discussion and talk and speak, but we have this, we're extremely interested. And our interest, our held interest into that topic, into that discussion, is almost like what feeds us in a way. You know, once you find something that really is your heart-rendering interest, yeah, absolutely, you are fed by it. It becomes it just becomes your life, you know, your what you really want to hear, what makes you impassioned in a way, impassioned over communication. So just like this little one just wanted to hear something trivial. It's like today I wrote a little something trivial. It was about the eggs, because we now have flax eggs out there, and they're wonderful, and it's just flax seeds, and you grind them, and you add water, and you stir it, and it gets like a thick, gooey emulsion, and then you put that in, and to any most recipes, and you have eggs, but they're flax. They're not from a hen. One of the I don't, how many are there, billion hens or something on the planet? I don't know, something ridiculous. But yeah, that's a number that we never needed to relegate that high. You know, for eating and processing, that's just disgusting. They should only be our pets, you know, our friends, and in the wild. Okay, so then over here, I'm like, well, so this discussion I had was a trivial kind, and I'm like, well, I can take it and go deeper, or I can just leave it at surface. And I just left it at the trivialism. I'm kind of just a little interested, but I have other things to do today. So I did not, for that person, I did not give, you know what I mean? I didn't give them the longer wavelength moment in my typing. I didn't. I just said, but then yet, all day long, I was thinking about the number 30%, because 30% was part of the recipe. And you can take the number 30%, you can take any percentage, and you can just go around and round and round and round and round and round and round, just what that 30% means. You know, does that 30% mean to this instance or that instance? You know, you can say, well, you know, 30% of my upper body is this much. 30%, you know, what does 30% mean to you? And oh my gosh, today it just 30% started meaning a whole bunch of things. And that's part of, we can call it word enlightenment. We can call it, word enlightenment. Because we have enlightenment, you know, where it's an expansionism and things just are just nonstop. Nonstop, a free, open space, available, and aware. Now, when you are with 30%, you take that percentage and you can go, well, I guess I have 30% of my life left. It could be that. It could be 30%. Oh, maybe only 30% of the men my age find me attractive. I could go with that. You know, you could say, well, 30% of the shoes in my closet I really never wear, or vice versa. You know, you could take those types of trivials with 30%. Or you can take something very serious. And then in that serious 30% wave, then I'm out there connecting yet again with others who are concentrating on 30% and what it means to them. And so I know that's a silly one, but in a way right now, I believe my foot is asleep, my ankle is asleep, all the way up to my knee. And so that would be like 30% of what? My body is numb. I don't know why it happens. I just get it. But it's going on. So yeah, so 30%. Yeah. So that's a serious 30%. So we have serious ones, but then it's not serious because I'll just move and rearrange it and let it wake up again, you know? It's not serious. But yeah. 30% of all gun owners maybe are safe handlers, and the others aren't. I mean, those types of things. That's serious and like so like media, isn't it? Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, yeah, A lot of the times, you know, when you hear a number or something, it does start to attain, go back to you and go like, how does that, is that pertaining to me in some manner? You know, is that something that is a reflection on me? You know, I'm a 30% failure, 30% chance of rain, you know, 30% chance of sunshine. It is, you know, the cup half full, the cup half empty. Where is your 30%? And there are some people that just all the time see their cup, all the time, half, way over half full. And they're just blithely optimistic. And as life is changing, and life is changing, as years go on and on, it is starting to be the 30% in the negative. And I'm like, whoa, fight it. Fight it. So I'm on the fight it wave, you know. Fight the negativity of that, of the your cup being, what do you call it? Not, what do they say it? You're not on the positive side or the negative side of life. Yeah. So we're. Yeah, it's that fight. You know, when it creeps in, a negative creeps in. You're like, stay away from me. And away, these waves that I was really talking about, these waves, when we're sending them out, we're sending them out through our head, our brain space wave, we are sending them out like all kinds of ways. You can send it out like a beautiful puffy cloud. You can send it out like a dagger. Yeah. You can send out energy like a dagger from your head. You can send out a long, long, long wave like a poet, a poem. Yeah. Anyway, that's what I really want to talk about tonight, was the waves and how they affect. And back to Hawking, how he's like, okay, It's there's a universe, and then it gets fat, and then it gets skinny in places, and does all of this, and it's just a mess. It's not a predictive factor that you can just say, yes, over there, that field of space is exactly this. It's very complicated. And so same with our speech. I mean, well, let's use that example with our speech, with our head speech, as it gets sent out. Am I sending out a fat headspace concentrative to people for a long, long time that they're interested in, or just something stupid and small and narrow and yet entertaining? Yeah. Anyway, something for the night, the space man is gone, and we will miss him.